NIHCM Foundation is pleased to present results for the 26th Annual General Circulation Journalism Award, which carries a prize of $20,000. This year's finalists are The Parking Lot Suicides from The Washington Post, Deadly Germs, Lost Cures from The New York Times, Unprotected, Broken Promises in Georgia's Senior Care Industry from the Atlanta Journal-Constitution, UVA Lawsuits from Kaiser Health News, The Washington Post, and Richmond Times-Dispatch, Betrayed by the Indian Health Service from The Wall Street Journal and PBS News Frontline, Marketing Hope from The Washington Post, Mental Health, A Crisis in Colorado from The Gazette, Tainted Pills, Broken Trust from Bloomberg Businessweek, and Lacking Oversight, Accountability in Mississippi's EMS Network from Mississippi Today and WLBT-TV. NIHCM thanks the independent panel of judges for their thoughtful consideration and expertise in selecting this year's winner.
Hello, I'm Eliza Barkley, the science and health editor at Vox and a judge of the general circulation category. Our panel of judges chose Noam Levy of the LA Times for his tremendous project on America's high deductible revolution. This was a really comprehensive series of stories using original polling data collected by the LA Times and the Kaiser Family Foundation that showed just the severe consequences of rising deductibles for tens of millions of Americans, particularly those with chronic disease who now do not have the savings to cover these medical costs and are incredibly stressed and avoiding care because of these rising costs that they can't cover. It was just a very powerful project and something that had great breadth and scope and impact. And now to accept the award is Noam Levy.
Thank you so much for this award. It's such an honor to have our series recognized in this way, and I'm so grateful to the many people who helped make it happen. I want to thank our research partners at the Kaiser Family Foundation, HCCI, and EBRI, the Commonwealth Fund and AHCJ, which funded reporting for this project in Europe, and my longtime editor, David Lauder, who shepherded these stories into print. Most of all, I want to thank the many people who agreed to share their stories with us, in some cases inviting me into their homes to talk about their struggles with medical bills, despite having health insurance. I've covered healthcare in this country for the better part of a decade now, much of it writing about the fight over the Affordable Care Act. But something else very profound has been happening to healthcare in America over the last 10 to 15 years, as high deductibles have come to fundamentally transform what it means to have insurance in America. This high deductible revolution was the subject of our project, and we wanted to try to understand the impact that deductibles were having on Americans with job-based benefits. Partnering with the Kaiser Family Foundation, we did a nationwide poll of more than 1,400 people with job-based health insurance. We did an extensive review of academic literature about the impact of cost sharing on patients. And we interviewed more than 150 people with job-based benefits. Some of these people were sick, some of them were healthy. They came from every region of the country and every income bracket. Many were struggling with debt and forced to make gut-wrenching sacrifices to pay their medical bills, including cutting back on food, taking on extra jobs, and moving in with friends and family. These stories form the backbone of our project, and taken together, I think they make the case that our experiment with high deductibles is failing. It is draining Americans' bank accounts, saddling them with debt. It is widening the gap between rich and poor and stoking political divisions. And it is making some of the most vulnerable among us terrified to go to the doctor or the hospital for fear of incurring medical bills. I hope you'll take a few minutes to read some of these stories. Thank you so much.
To learn more about this year's awards, visit the National Institute for Healthcare Management site at www.nihcm.org.